tree, bending beneath the weight of his wind and mercy. When all of a sudden I am unaware of these afflictions eclipsed by glory, and I realize just how beautiful you are and how great your affections are for me. And oh, how he loves us. Oh, oh, how he loves us. How he loves us all. Oh. For me, love's like a hurricane. I am a tree bending beneath the weight of his wind and mercy. When all of a sudden I am unaware of these afflictions eclipsed by glory, and I realize just how
How's everybody doing tonight? That was weak. How's everybody doing tonight?
That's much better. That's much better. My name is John Atchison. I'm the worship pastor here at Renew. So thankful that you came tonight. We are glad to have you. I'm excited. This is the second time that Mark has brought a crew through to Renew, and so we're glad to have these guys with us tonight. We just encourage you to make yourself at home. Have fun. Enjoy the night. I will say that these guys are just kind of rolling through, getting their names out. Some of them are going to go back out on the road tomorrow to do the same thing. So show them some love. Enjoy the night. If you've never been to Renew and you're looking for a church home, shameless plug, we'd love to have you. Hope you come back. It's a very relaxed atmosphere. They let me come in jeans and shirts like this all the time, so that's good. But we hope that you come. If you have a church home, please continue to go there. We want you to enjoy and grow in God's love. But if you want a place to come and be able to be yourself and be loved, we'd love to have you as well. I will say that we did not charge for tonight, but we would like to take donations if it's possible for you. So we're not asking you to. We're just saying if you have the ability, these guys are working their rear ends off to you know, have a good show for you tonight. Would love for you to just bless them as well as they go to help cover some of the travel expenses, and maybe they could eat somewhere other than McDonald's for the next few days. That would be good too. But again, guys, y'all can go ahead and come on up. I'm going to let them take over, and I'm going to be quiet and go to the back. Thank you again for coming. We love you for being here. Have fun and enjoy tonight.
Good evening, y'all.
Hey, y'all.
Y'all.
Hey, y'all.
I'm not from the South.
I'm from South Carolina. Who would have thunk it?
Y'all. So how y'all doing tonight?
How are y'all doing tonight?
You guys ready to worship the Lord? Hey, you know, we were told by your pastor that right now there are 3 tornadoes down in Oklahoma City. And so why don't we just take a second and pray for them?
Yeah.
Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you, God, that you love us and you have made us accepted by the perfect sacrifice of your Son. And that is how we come to you right now, God, knowing that whatever we ask in his name, that we will receive. And so, Father, we just pray for your miraculous intervention, God, for these tornadoes in Oklahoma City. The city's already experienced so much chaos and disaster in the last days, Lord. We pray for your peace. We pray for your divine intervention in this situation. We thank you for it. In Jesus' name. Everyone said amen.
Amen.
Hey, where's Mr. Henry at? Is he in here? Henry, there's a gentleman who's celebrating his 81st birthday. I gotta say his name right? Henry? Where's he at?
Where you at?
Henry!
Stand up, Henry.
Stand up, buddy. Yeah. Happy birthday to you. We do it different. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. God bless you, Henry. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday.
Yeah. Amen.
Come on, everybody, get on your feet. Come on, everybody.
Blessed be your name in a land that is plentiful, where streams of abundance flow. Blessed be your name. Blessed be. Blessed be your name
in a land that is plentiful, where your streams of abundance flow. Blessed be your name. The blessings you pour out turn back to face when the darkness closes in, Lord. Still I will say,
blessed be
the name of the
blessed be.
Blessed be your name, the sun shining down on me. The world's all as it should be. Blessed be your name.
Every blessing
you pour out, I'll turn back to face. When the darkness closes in my eyes, still I will say, name of the Lord, blessed be your name.
Your glorious name.
Give and take away.
Give and take away.
Come on, sing it out.
Give and take away.
Yeah, yeah.
My heart will choose to say.
Choose to say.
Blessed be your name.
Come on. You
give.
You are the everlasting God.
God.
Brandy Allison. I'm from South Carolina, and I want to share a little bit of my testimony with all of you. First of all, I want to say I'm really excited to be here in Arkansas. I'm single, and I'm looking for a cowboy. I love cowboys, let me tell you. I used to come this way. I used to haul cattle. Yes, I did. And I've jumped a couple of fences. I used those shock sticks and them whips. Every time a cow would turn around, we was running them up in them chutes and trying to get them up in them 18-wheelers. Every time a cow would turn around, I'd run. And every time I'd run, they'd scatter. And my husband, he used to get so mad at me. He would just get so mad. That's what I want to talk to you about. 3 years ago, August the 20th, 2010, I was married to this wonderful cowboy. He was a cowboy. My life changed forever. I was not saved. I was not a Christian 3 years ago. At 5:30 on August the 20th, I hugged my husband for the last time ever. At 6:30, I spoke on the phone, and he told me he loved me for the last time. At 7:30, my husband crashed his motorcycle doing 120 miles per hour and was killed instantly. And I got the phone call, and when I went into the hospital, remember, I wasn't a Christian, and I wasn't saved. I hadn't talked to God in 10 years. My mama took me to church. I knew all the stories, but I wasn't living my life right. I was using methamphetamines and cocaine for 11 years. And I went into a private waiting room, and this was before I knew he was dead. And I said, God, you ain't taking my husband tonight. You're not going to do that to me. I won't allow it. 2 seconds later, the doctors walked in, and they said, sweetheart, he didn't make it. His heart wasn't strong enough. I remember waking up for the first time without him. I walked in the bathroom, and I said, God, this ain't happening. This ain't happening to me. It just can't be. He was walking by my side then. I felt him. He was an experience. And then a week later, after I buried him, started setting in a little bit. A month later, it was unbearable. A year later, I was coming to grips with it. 3 years later, I'm standing right here in front of you, giving this testimony, singing songs for the Lord. I'm gonna share with you my new single called Walking on Faith, and this song comes from my testimony. And it is available on iTunes, and it's called Walking on Faith. My whole world falls apart, and I just don't know where to start. Need a friend, but no one is listening. I keep walking on faith. I lay it out in your hands, all my world.
on faith. When my night ends all alone and I break down driving home, and every move that I make feels like my fate, I keep walking on faith. I lay it out in your hands, all my world, all my plans, only you bring out the best in me. When I've made a mess of me, when my head is almost gone and I'm barely hanging on, I'm taking just about all I can take. And suddenly you light the way with your grace. I keep walking on faith.
Disguise.
How about a nice hand for Brandy tonight? Her testimony has, over this last 4 or 5 days, has really touched my life. You know, we've all been through some crazy things in our life. We've all had loss. We've all had some gain. But this music that she is singing is truthfully what brought her to Christ. And I just think that it was awesome. One of the things that she shared, that when she turned on the radio station, that what was the third day song? It was
Born Again.
She heard Born Again, and it touched her life. And next thing you know, she's praying. 3 years later, she's up on the stage singing about the goodness of and the gospel of Jesus Christ. I don't know about you, but I'm thankful for Brandy tonight. Will you let her know you appreciate her? Come on. Proud of you. Proud of you. She took tragedy and made it triumph, and I love it. I love it. It's only the grace of God. Sing.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now am found. Was blind, but now I see. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me.
Sing along.
I once was lost, but now am found. Was blind, but now I see.
Such grace that taught my heart to fear. Just grace my fears relieved. Precious did that grace appear, the eye I first believed.
See, my chains are
mine. I've been set free. I got my stay.
Good to me. Amen. Let's give the Lord a hand. Kelsey Craig, hailing from the land of the northern southern plains. I can't figure out if Florida's in the north or the south, man.
Huh? It's the deep south.
It's in the south, but I'm from Pennsylvania. I'm obviously a Yankee, right? You guys would like tar and feather me and put me out of town. Yeah, see? Okay, afterwards. Just wait till after. But I get off this plane from Pennsylvania, and we talk like this. We obviously have a speech impediment. And I fly into Miami, and I swear everyone's from Queens. Like, there wasn't a single southern person there. Is that true?
What's Queens, New York?
Queens, Brooklyn. I'm serious. Everyone talk with the New York accent.
In Florida.
Yeah. So anyway, this is Kelsey, and she's going to sing a lovely song.
Yes, this is a song that I just released on iTunes, that I wrote with Mark Harris.
And we like it.
We love it. I can't stop singing it.
And it's going to be real good. Real good. Can you feel the anticipation? You feel it building? Here it is.
Sing it, Cam.
Yeah.
darkness you took me in. So I deserved. With open arms you welcomed me, gave my past, you made me clean. You gave me breath. The moon, the earth, the stars on high, they only stand to testify. The universe cannot contain the wonder and the mystery.
Let's sing that again to him. Worthy is none, Lamb who was slain. Holy, holy is he. We sing to you tonight. We sing a new song to him who sits right. Heaven's mercy. Come on, with our hands.
Serve a good God. Well, hey, y'all can just have a seat real quick. I like saying y'all. I'm going to say it a lot. Just rolls off the tongue, you know. Seriously, y'all are a lot nicer down here than up in the Northeast. The farther you go up the Northeast, the meaner people get. And I'm serious, man. I live in a university town in the Northeast, and we're all snippy with each other. So, well, my name's Alan. I am from Pennsylvania. And I just want to tell you a little bit about my story. So I was born on the West Coast in a little town close to Seattle. And I was a Navy brat, Navy kid. And my brother and I both were conceived out of an affair that my mom had. And my stepdad, the guy who kind of raised me for a little bit, I'll get into that. He knew that I wasn't his, but he didn't know that my brother wasn't his. And so he would go away for a couple months at a time on a sub, and those were the times when we came about. And I've been saying that, you know, sin is bad, but in my case, I'm glad. You know what I'm saying, right? So, anyway. So, but there's always instability in my house. I mean, from the very, right out of the gate, my parents were screaming at each other and fighting. You can imagine how that, at the front end of a relationship, would cause, you know, trust issues. And so I just, we moved to the East Coast. My parents were always fighting, and I remember that, you know, my parents had separated, and my dad had custody, or my stepdad had custody of my brother and I, and my mom would see us on the weekends. And this one weekend, my stepdad had decided that he was going to go and move back to the West Coast, and we were going to be out of the picture with my mom. And like any mom, you know, she wanted her babies around. And so she told me, she said, this will be the last time you're going to see your father. He dropped us off for a custody visit, and I just remember freaking out. You got to remember, I live with the guy. He was my dad. And I just remember screaming and trying to get to the phone. And that I only saw him one time after that. And I don't want to say anything bad about my mom. She was just doing what she had to do, you know. So I remember growing up just being on the playground, and I remember having a lot of rejection was the thing that I always, that was what I was always carrying around. You know, I always wanted everyone to like me, and I was always getting made fun of. This is probably a similar story. You know, I'm not unique. Everybody's parents, or 55% of us, have had their parents get divorced and have gone through it, and or have been divorced. But God is a healer, amen? He can restore. And so I know I'm not unique, but I just hope that this ministers to you. So my mom, she had instilled faith in my brother and I at a very young age. And I said the sinner's prayer when I was 3. I don't know if I was actually saved or not, but I knew God was real, at the very least, you know. So my mom was raising us as a single mom, and she worked really hard to put us in, you know, Christian schools and everything. And I remember I was searching for acceptance, and I didn't want to be there. I didn't want to be in the Christian school. I knew God was real, and I knew that I didn't want anything to do with him, and I was running from him. So when I was like 12 or 13 years old, I started, you know, taking drugs and started messing around with LSD and stuff when I was young. And I don't want to go through all the details, but basically I got kicked out of that school, and I ended up going to the public school system. And around that time, my mom got into another marriage, and it was just a nightmare, really bad. And that guy ended up being arrested and taken out of the house for domestic abuse. And by the time I was supposed to be graduating from high school, my younger brother and I were both in drug and alcohol rehabs. And just running from the Lord. And that was when I was like 17 or 18. I got out of that rehab. And I knew that I wasn't ready to surrender to the Lord. He's a gentleman. You know, he wasn't pushing me into anything. And over the next couple years, I just was running. And I, you know, when I was 11 years old, I started playing music, stole my brother's guitar and kept it. And he turned to a drummer, but he's a good, darn good one too. But I say that to say that I eventually, you know, I used to play for like 5 hours a day. I would just write music. It was my passion. And as the years went on and I went through drug and alcohol addiction, I just sold all of my equipment. I lost my passion. And when I was like 19 years old, I started, you know, I stole a bunch of money and drugs from a drug dealer in the town that I lived in, stole a car, moved to a, or went to a major city, sold it, and then moved down to Texas, where I lived in the, I lived in Sodom, Oaklawn, which is the second largest community for alternative lifestyle. I lived down there, and I just smoked crystal meth. And that eventually ended up with me being homeless. I was just for quite a while, I was just down there. I got so depressed, and so I came back to Pennsylvania. But I wasn't ready for God to reach into my life and intervene yet, so I just kept running. I was a loser. I was a thief. If you were my friend, I would steal from you. I mean, I was just, I was running. And I just remember that I would, during the day, you know, I would wake up from just drunk, hungover, feeling like garbage. And just didn't know who I'd lied from or who I'd stolen from. I had the police looking for me for years. I was always staying a couple steps ahead of them because I had warrants out for my arrest, lots of them. And so I was always running. And I was living a life of shame. I knew I was a loser. I knew that I would never play music or never do anything that God had called me to do because I was stuck in a lifestyle and I couldn't get out of it. So this one summer, I was 21 and I was inebriated. I don't know what I was on. And I just remember thinking, I can't live like this anymore. And so I hit my knees behind this guy's house. I don't know. Yeah, there's nothing special about that place. And I said, God, help me. I can't do this. I can't stop. And then I got up and walked away and forgot about it. About 3 months later, God answered my prayer through the police. Constable Jesus came. And I remember I was in jail. Praise God, you know. Praise God, man. Because I was caught in a cycle. When I was in prison, there's no one that I could, there's nothing that could pull me in there. It's just Alan and God time. And I remember it was my 19th day. Thinking, I don't have to live like this anymore. It took 19 days before the light went on. Prison food was terrible. And it was 19 days of it, and I was like, this sucks. And I was in jail for a while, and I ended up going to rehab. And I had a Christian counselor, which is very rare. And I just remember he would take me to his church on Sundays after the, you know, from the rehab unit. I just remember this one Sunday, God just rocked me for about 40 minutes. And he just began doing these awesome things in my life. And that was in 2001, and the end of 2001, and that was the last time I had a drug or any kind of alcohol in my system, and except for caffeine. You know, I've seen God be so faithful over the last 11 years, 12 years. Time's going fast now. In my life, he has restored my life. In 2006, I married an amazing woman who came out of the same, she was a cocaine addict, came out of the same lifestyle, and God put her family together. And you know, the most powerful thing that happened to me was in 2008. You know, I'd been walking with God, you know, as a worship leader and doing all kinds of stuff for about 7 years in 2008. But I felt, I was on this, how many of you have ever felt like you failed God? Go ahead and raise your hand. You can all raise it. How many of you have ever felt, as a Christian, that you had disqualified yourself from God's blessing and favor? You can all raise your hand, right? We've all felt like that, right? And what I learned was that God is not relating to us on the basis of us and our performance. He is relating to us on the basis of Jesus Christ and his perfect performance. Jesus Christ perfectly obeyed for 33 years. And because he was perfectly obedient, he was fully qualified to receive all of the blessings from a just God. And on the cross, credit for all of your sin was transferred into his perfect account, and he became your sin. And credit for his absolute perfection was transferred into your account. And you receive credit for the perfect obedience of Jesus Christ. And God is not relating to you today on the basis of you and what you can do and your performance. He is relating to you on the basis of Jesus Christ and that he perfectly obeyed. You are fully qualified to receive all of the blessings that Jesus deserves because he gave you credit for his perfect obedience. Isn't that good news? He who knew no sin became sin for you so that you would become the righteousness of God in Christ. And I just want to say this. I know I'm not supposed to talk this long, but I just want to tell you guys this. God's success in your life is not dependent upon you and your ability. God cannot fail at anything that he starts. Can God fail? Can you raise your hand if you think God can fail at something? In the back. She's putting her hand down. Put it down. The reality is God cannot fail at anything he starts, anything he begins. Who began the good work in you? Can God fail? He will not fail in you. Even when your performance is lacking, his faithfulness is not dependent upon you. It is a gift, and he looks at you as completely obedient and as completely perfect as Jesus Christ. Isn't that good news? So that's what my song's about. It's called God in Me. The God that is inside of us will not fail in us, for us, and through us. He is God in us, and he will succeed. Hope you like it. When I'm afraid and I can't find my way, your faithfulness remains. When storms they rage, when my strength begins to fade, give me eyes of faith. You give faith to the faithless. Oh, you open eyes, eyes too blind to see. You are higher. Oh, oh, you are stronger. Oh, oh. Listen to this. You are higher. You are stronger. God of victory.
Guys, you'll find out that they believe quite a few things. They believe that there's one true God. They believe He created the universe. You'll hear the Word of God sung in many of these choruses that they've been singing tonight. You'll hear the Word of God come out of them as part of their testimony. It's because they believe the Word of God is real and alive. They believe it brings life. I woke up this morning, I was tired, I don't know about you guys, and thought, man, Can I finish the week strong? Can I serve these guys like I'm supposed to? And I open up my email. It's a bad habit I have in the morning. Find out if I'm in trouble. And I'm scrolling out through my email, and there's my verse for the day, you know. So I pop it open, and it says, a little paraphrase, but, you know, even young guys get tired. But you can soar with wings like eagles. Yeah. Ever seen an eagle fly? You don't see very many of them crash, do they? They're flying, and they don't go, yeah, I'm tired now. I think I'll go down. They just fly and higher and higher and higher, run and not grow weary, don't get tired. God's word was alive for me this morning. Somebody formed that email probably at the first of the year and set it to automatically send out, but God knew what I needed to read. His word was alive for me. I've got one I want to read to you now. This was, I'm going to take off my glasses so I can read. I wear them so I can not trip over things and take them off so I can read. I've called you by name. You are mine. When you pass through the waters, I'll be with you. And through the rivers, they shall not overwhelm you. When you walk through fire, you shall not be burned, and the flame shall not consume you, because you are precious in my eyes and honored, and I love you. That's the God of the universe, the creator, the one that they've been singing about, saying he loves you. And he's going to protect you, defend you, lift you up, and shield you. That's something to hold on to today. No matter how tired we are tonight, no matter how discouraged we are tonight, what verse do you have that you hold on to? These guys are going to share some verses with you that have ministered to them. You think about that verse that you hold on to when the time is dark. God's word is alive. Let it speak to you. Let it live and breathe.
Word of God, speak. Would you pour out thy rain?
Would you sing this with us? God speak.
Word of God speak. Would you pour down that rain? See my eyes to see your majesty. To be still and know you're in this place. Please let me stay.
God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life.
Amen. Amen. My favorite scripture probably right now that I love, well, the one that's just speaking to me right now, you know, is about purpose and it's about destiny. It's one of these things where you never know where God's going to take you and what he's doing. I mean, who would have thought? I've been traveling for 21 years on the road, and here I am starting a whole fresh, brand new thing. You're talking about a crab out of a shell. Out of this water, out of a shell. You know, this is a total different deal for me, you know. And when we think we're so accustomed and we get comfortable and we get in our routine, get ready. If you really want to move and you really want to be in the center of God's will, you have no clue where he's going to take you. Jeremiah 1:4-5, you know, the scripture says, you know, before I formed thee, I knew thee, I sanctified thee, I ordained thee a prophet. In other words, you know, before you come out of your mother's womb, he had a plan for your life. He had a destiny for your life. There was purpose already. You know, and I know that he was talking to Jeremiah when he said this. You know, he was calling him to minister. And Jeremiah, he was going, hey, you know, how can I minister? How can I do these things? I'm just a child. And he told him, he said, don't worry about that. I'll give you what to say. Because he already had a plan. He already had a path for him. And I look at that and I say, thank you, Lord, because you're no respecter of persons. The very reason that I have breath in my body is because you have something for me to do. The very reason that I'm living at all is because for some reason you've called me to do something. Can I tell you something? The very reason that you're alive and you're sitting in this seat right now is because God has something in store for your life. He has a plan. He has a purpose. He has a destiny for you. How many would raise a hand and by that say this? I know that there's more to life than what I'm living. And you know, that is it for all of us, isn't it? A lot of times. We know that God has more for us, but we're scared, we're nervous, we can't see it. I know all of the things that the enemy says, to us. Well, you know, I can't afford it. I don't know how I will fund it. Anybody say amen to that? But here's what he expects you to do. He owns a cattle on 1,000 hills. The government's exchange doesn't matter to him. He can just pull, well, matter of fact, he could just chip off a little of the, you know, the streets up there and send it down your way. Here's what he wants us to do is believe and take a step. That's all he wants us to do. Believe and take a step. Here I am today. I'm believing and taking a step that God has another path for me. Can I tell you something? God has a path for you. And I'm excited about your future. You might say, well, I'm halfway done. You don't understand. I'm older now and I'm just ready to sit back and relax. Don't sit back and relax too much because you might just go on and be out of here. There's work to be done. There is people right now as we are sitting here that has been hurting like Brother Allen, you know, that is waiting for somebody to come along and say, hey, listen, you need to hear the good news of the gospel of Jesus Christ. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son that whosoever should believe in him should not perish but have everlasting life. You know, that's the good news. People say, well, I just don't know what I'm called to do. Well, I know what you're called to do, be an ambassador for the Lord Jesus Christ. Period. He can use your gifts for that. I'm not a singer. Well, sow something. And I'm not talking about giving. Make a blanket for somebody. Whatever your gift is, you can use it to glorify God and to bring people to the Lord. You believe that? I don't know if y'all believe it or not. You're sitting there going, look like a dying calf in a hailstorm. Hello? I said, do you believe that God has something in store for your life? Well, then why don't you give him praise for it? Why don't you give him some glory for it? Why don't you give him some honor for it? Because he is worthy, amen? The reason that there is purpose and there is hope is Jesus Christ is alive. He raised on the third day and took the keys of death, hell, and the grave away. Hello, somebody, give the Lord a hand clap. Why don't you stand to your feet and give him a hand clap of praise? He's worthy. I said he's worthy. He's worthy. I don't want no rock crying out in my place. He's worthy. Amen. Yeah. I know my Redeemer lives. Come on, sing it. I know my Redeemer lives. And let all creation testify. Let this life within me cry. I know my Redeemer, he lives. Oh, he lives. Who taught the sun where to stand in the morning? Listen. Who told the ocean you can only come this far? Think about it. And who showed the moon where to hide till evening? Whose words alone can catch a falling star? You know what? Sing it with me. Well, I know my Redeemer. You know that? Yeah. I know my Redeemer lives. Let all creation testify. Let this life within me cry. I know my Redeemer, he lives. Well, I know my Redeemer lives. Come on, sing it. I know my Redeemer lives. Come on. Let all creation testify that the same one within me cry. Yes, I know that I know my Redeemer, he lives. Yeah, yes, he lives. Oh, I know he lives. Can I sing that chorus one more time? Yeah. Oh, I know my Redeemer lives. I know my Redeemer. Come on. Let all testify. Let this cry. I know my Redeemer. He lives. Yeah, he lives. Ooh, I know he lives now. 'Cause I walk with him. I freely talk to him. I've been there. The grave is empty. I know that I know that I know and I know that I know he lives. Oh yeah, yeah. I just won't sing like I'm feeling in my spirit right now, if that's all right. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yes, I know that he lives. I know that he lives. Yeah, yeah. Come on, turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor. Don't act like you're talking to them. Come on, get their attention. Say, neighbor, do you know? Do you know? Do you know that Jesus lives? That Jesus lives. Come on and tell them. Say, he's alive. He's alive. He's alive. One more time. Yeah, I know my Redeemer. I want somebody praising. Come on, come on. Yes, I know my Redeemer lives. Oh, Lord of creation, testify that this life within me cry. I know my Redeemer. Yes. Come on, give him a hand clap of praise. Come on, give him a hand clap of praise. Hallelujah. Woo. I know he lives. Man, that excites me right there. Amen. It excites me that he said, I will never leave you. I'll never forsake you. No matter what you're going to face, no matter if you're good or bad, no matter if people like you or they don't. Friends may leave you. Family may forsake you. Church people may leave you out. They might judge you a little bit. Maybe they think you've gone a little too far. Whatever the case may be, he said, I'll be with you even to the end. I love you. This song's called Near. Woo. Yeah, you can stay standing if you want to.
How can a world so beautiful be so cold, be so cruel? Sometimes love just seems so far away. Suffering is no stranger here. It breaks my heart, beats my fear, trying to steal my hope and my faith.
Oh, I love this. Ooh.
but I believe you when you say that you are near. Whenever I feel alone, I'm not on my own. God, I know you're standing here. You are near. When all the world seems dark, still I know you are the light that will always find me here. You are. We know you're here with us in our tears, in this dust, reaching in ways sometimes we just can't see. Lord, I love this. You'll never leave and never will. Your love saves, does not fail. So lead us to be your hands and feet until the world sees that you are near. Whenever I feel alone, I'm not on my own. God, I know you're standing here. You are near. When all the world seems dark, still we know you are the light that will always find me. Your life was taken by your death. We are awakened. We will never be forsaken now. Not like this now. You're alive and hope has risen. Hearts restored and are forgiven. Love is here to stay. Love is here to say that you are near. Alone. I'm not on my own. But God, I know you're standing here. You are here. When all the world seems dark, still we know you are the light that will always find me here. God, I know you're standing here. You are near.
Woo! Somebody say amen. Oh, I'm about to sing out. Man, I'm telling you, 16 stops in 5 days and singing at 6 o'clock in the morning. This crab's about shot. Come on. Come on, don't sit down on it.